to grace, strength to strength, all for your glory. Brick by brick, day by day, building your story. Grace to grace, strength to strength, all for your glory.
The day the Lord has made, so what are we waiting for? La 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 la. I paid my duty. Oh, what in the...
The Church Kid Show.
Church Kid Show, Church Kid Show, Church Kid Show.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to The Church Kid Show. I'm Charles Good.
And I'm Sophia. Today is the final lesson of our series on generosity.
Yes! Our faith declaration is, I am generous because God is generous with me. But before we get any further, it's competition time! Let's do it!
Yes, today we will be playing one of my favorite competitions titled Eat It or Wear It.
Wait, that's not, maybe it's not competition time yet because, you know, I mean, I don't want to wear food. You know, I'm gonna try and eat it all.
Do it, eat it. You want to explain the game?
If you don't know what Eat It or Wear It is, it's kind of how it sounds. We're given an item that's somewhat edible for human consumption, and then we either have to choose to eat it or wear it. Wear it meaning sew it into your denim vest and wear it on the set. No, it means pour it onto your head. That's what it means. You know, this seems like get messy. Before we get started, Sophia, jack it off!
Let's transition into our trash bags. Ready?
Nice. At least they got the right size.
Okay, ready?
It doesn't smell horrendous. It's a big bite.
Oh, cold.
Oh, it's cold? That's gonna make it worse.
I did it. Oh, spicy, spicy.
Oh, foo-foo popo. Next we have, what is it?
It's marshmallows and something. Cheese? Is that cheese?
It's like nacho cheese.
Ew.
That looks like a fungus is what it looks like. That looks like stuff that, it's like oozing out of a tree. Oh, what in the?
Oh, what in the?
What are you doing?
My arm spasmed.
Oh, sure. Now I'm wearing it, so I guess I don't have to eat it. Check.
Eat as much as you want.
No.
You worry?
I think I'm gonna wear some of this.
We're both going to? You just wanna scoop it?
Yeah. Yeah! All on the ground. So this is actually making me happy. Are you ready? Oh, it just, I need to get this. Is it cold? Is it? Oh, it literally, oh, I'm just gonna stop. Oh, okay, get this out of here, please.
Oh, this does not smell bad though. This smells good.
This looks like cleaner fluid. She's eating it.
It tastes like pineapple. It tastes yummy. It tastes like pineapple and blue Kool-Aid.
Yeah, you know what? Just going in for a second bite just to...
You just...
Next!
I'm eating
it. That's tapioca pudding. But it... Hold on, but it has corn in it. So is it corn pudding?
Maybe it's fish eggs.
That's fine with me.
What? Rip it! Purple. Is that purple? That's purple.
It's like taro. I like taro.
You do?
Taro's delicious. What are you talking about? I'm keeping this one.
But this looks worse than that does.
That looks like oatmeal with like cereal in it.
Oh, smell it.
Oh. Hold on. It's because we're going from sweet to savory.
No, that smells disgusting.
No, you have to sit with it for a second.
I'm not sitting with that.
Okay.
What is this? This looks way worse than his does. What? I'm gonna throw up.
Oh no. No, I can't eat that together. This thing's not gonna, it's just gonna like fall off of you.
Yeah, but do you smell that?
Yeah.
I'm gonna gag.
Come on. Oh, oh, oh. Listen to that.
No.
Oh! Oh, there it goes!
Ew! Look at it.
It's alive! It's dancing!
Oh! Ew, look, it's just like rock solid. Okay.
Okay,
ready?
Oh, that's cold and wet. It's cold and wet. It sounds like it's alive!
Here, I'll help
no,
you
up. No. I have paid my duty. Jesus died for my sins. Oh, well, church kids, now that we have concluded this segment, we're gonna see what game you're playing for today. So let's get to it. Ah!
What's up, church kids? And it is game time. We are about to get into a game I like to call Defend Your Mallow. All right, now behind me, you are gonna see one, two, three, four marshmallows on your side of the table, all right? There's gonna be two contestants, and your goal is to throw or roll this marshmallow across the table and knock the opponent's marshmallow off. The person with the most mallows at the end of the 60 seconds wins the game.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
It up a little bit.
Oh, give, and it will come back to you.
It will come back.
Good measure, press down, shaking together and running over. Give, and it will come back to you.
It will come back. It will come back.
When you give, give to the Lord.
All right, let me tell you something about giving. When you give, it comes back to you. Shaking round together, boiling like a pot of stew. Give me one, no, two, no, three more times to give. I think I'll be generous as long as I shall live. Cause generosity is my morning cup of tea. It really gives me the greatest type of energy. Jesus sees you give, thinks it's really great. Now let's go back to check out Luke 6:38.
Oh, hey. Give, and it will come back to you.
It will come back.
Good measure, press down, shaking together and
now we are all cleaned up. So, Sophia, can you explain the...
You know, all those smells going on, I really had to get something nice.
Nice and fresh. Yeah, well, I had to scrub potato out of my locks and clams and Oreo shreds. So that's what's brewing up. And then we found this nice clean towel, which, you know, I think this could be a good look for me. What do you think?
It looks great.
Thank you.
More luscious.
As long as it's not, like, pulling, you know... Yeah. Skin off my face.
Anyways, our memory verse this month is Luke 6:38, which says, "Give and it will come back to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. It will be poured into your lap." God loves a cheerful giver.
Sure does. And when we joyfully share with others around us, we are showing God's love. When we give what we have with excitement, we are storing up for ourselves treasures in heaven.
That's right. Our stuff doesn't last, but the good things that come from leading a generous life last forever and ever.
Mm-hmm. Jesus would say things like, "Look at the birds. They don't store food for themselves, but they have enough." Or the wildflowers that are beautiful and strong. They don't stress about their existence or if there would be enough water to help them grow. When we give Jesus our hearts and believe that God will always provide for our needs, we start to see opportunities for generosity everywhere. with our time, attention, and even our money.
Yes, the best way to experience the abundance of what God has for us is to share with others, because we trust that God will take care of all of our needs, because God is a generous God.
That's right. Let's take a look at what else our lesson is going to teach us about generosity.
Just sitting back.
And enjoying a nice cup of hot chocolate.
Get cozy.
And hang on for the loop.
That sounds nice.
4, 3, 2, 1. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
I'm Ricky.
And I'm Jamie. Ricky, do you like hot chocolate or are you more of a hot cider kind of person?
Ooh, definitely hot chocolate. I love it when you can add some cinnamon to it and some marshmallows. Oh, forget about it.
That's fancy. Okay, so I like hot cider during the fall and I like hot chocolate during the winter time, but only if it has marshmallows and or whipped cream.
Today on The Loop Show, we're talking about a hot topic, hot cocoa. No, hot cheese. No, for real, money.
Ooh, money's on that list of things that can sometimes be hard to talk about.
People in the Bible worried and fought about money a lot.
All the adults I know fight and worry about money too.
Maybe you have some money and you don't know what to do with it.
If you're not sure how much to give, this show is for you.
Now, we know that generosity is more than just about money, but we are facing the topic of money head on.
We don't pull punches here on The Loop Show.
No, we don't play games. And unrelated, we are going to a segment called Action Figure Theater.
Ooh.
Do you speak English?
Yes. Yeah, just kidding. You probably thought I just bad.
Do you think having money is bad?
Are you talking about money? Bucks? Cabbage? Cash?
Is having money bad? Are you really asking me, is having money bad?
No, money's not bad. Money's great. I've got big plans with my money. I'm saving it up so I can buy a rocket and blast the moon out of smithereens. I'm planning on destroying the moon. Have I told you that, Daryl?
Isn't money the root of all evil?
No, money's not the root of all evil. The taco I had last night's the root of all evil, if you know what I'm saying. Oh my gosh, my stomach.
What are you talking about? Are you talking about dough? Coin? Currency?
How can money help?
Once I get that money, I'm gonna spend it on a brand new video game. I get $58, I get $59, I get $60, I spend it. It's gone.
Like, I'm a giver, so like, I wanna give it all away. But my parents are like, hey, you can't give away everything that you have because like, we bought it for you. And I'm like, well, that doesn't sound very generous.
How do you make money?
I don't know, I just take it from other dinosaurs. And then I like spending it at the dino store.
Hey, street man, you talking about legal tender? You talking about Lolly?
Do you two fight about money?
Oh, we're roommates, and yeah, we get into it. We definitely do. No, we never. I mean, I don't remember us having ever any fights about money. Dude, you never pay for your half of anything. What are you talking about, man? And I did the dishes last night. I'm not talking about the dishes. It's about favors. I scratch his scales, he scratches mine. I don't have scales. I've never had scales. I've never had scales.
I don't really have any fights about money because I don't really have any money. My mom and dad fight about money a lot, I can tell you that. What's that target box on the front porch? And my mom is like, I didn't do anything. I didn't order anything. We needed new candles. I'm sorry. And then we have a lot of candles.
I'm not done yet. You talking about pelf? You talking about loot?
Can you be generous without money?
No, of course not. You need money to be generous. Everybody knows that.
Generous? Without money? I've never thought of that. I mean, I don't have money because I'm a horse.
What, you want to know about tender? Is that what it is? Well, I could tell you. What was the question?
Really enjoying learning about money while sipping on this hot beverage.
Yeah, this is an unruinable moment.
Ooh, hello, mystery hand. Somebody smart took chocolate and heated it up to make a delicious beverage. True. Which got us wondering, are there other beverages that would be better heated up? Take a big sip and let us know. Better hot or not?
We have three mugs with a variety of colors. And none of this looks like it's chocolate. We are told that this first one is hot orange juice.
You warm up apple juice to get apple cider. Why not do the same thing with orange juice?
I think it's worth trying. Why not?
One, two, three.
Oh, wow. Ooh. That's acidic. But not bad.
It's almost like tarty.
Not that it's like late for class, but like very tart. I'm gonna say that is better not on a scale of one to five. The hot things, I'm gonna give it a two hots.
All right, that's four. Give it to me for breakfast.
You would have this for breakfast? Just like, oh, let me just warm up some orange juice and...
I mean, I would prefer it cold, but I don't really care.
All right, next one. This one seems to have a sour gummy garnish to it. And there are things in this. This is hot sour Skittle water. I don't know how that works. This is a hot cup of liquid
sour
hot
Skittles.
Sour Skittle water. None of this makes sense to me.
I don't like sour.
I need an explanation from everyone on my desk by the end of the day. Why and how?
It looks like tomato soup.
It like does a, look like tomato
okay,
soup.
Okay, I guess let's take a sip.
Mmm.
Okay, wow.
Whoa, that's actually good.
That is surprisingly good. Man, I had a lot of dread for nothing.
Yeah, me too.
That is delightful. This, I mean, come on. Pumpkin spice Cheers latte, get out of here. We have sour Skittle water. Still working on the name.
I don't even like sour Skittles, and I love this drink.
I really like this.
It tastes like you can taste the rainbow, but it's just warmer and like in a more chiller, candlelit mood, you know? Five hot. This is really, really good hot.
I do think that it'd be really good in like a snow cone or something.
This would be amazing as a snow cone.
Yeah.
Oh, man. All right, so this last cup is garnished with a nice little candy cane. Oh, my goodness.
Do you recognize the candy cane?
No.
It's like acidic.
Jamie?
It's eating. Oh, mine's completely gone. Yeah, I recognize the
candy cane.
It's a clandy cane. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. Dear. Please send help.
The clam water. Remember clam water?
People just bottle it. They put it in a bottle.
It's clam juice. Everyone's favorite juice. Oh.
Oh.
Oh, gosh.
Right on the arm. Oh, you can rub it into the skin.
And they say, hey, you know what? New hot drink of the winter season. Clam juice water.
All right, Jamie, let's take a sip.
Okay.
Let's take a sip. All right. You ready? You ready?
One, two, three. I exited my human body for a second there.
Lucky.
Oh. That is awful.
It's times like this, I wish I didn't have a tongue. It tasted like something dead. I'm just really sad.
Why would you take the juice of a clam?
It should never be done.
You take the juice of a clam and say, let's heat this puppy up.
If I were to rate this on a scale of 1 to 5, I would rate it a run as fast as you can. I honestly think, if I am being honest, someone who would probably enjoy this drink, quiz man.
Cha-ching! The buck stops here. Time for the quiz thing. Gold, hard, cash. I mean, when you think about it, it's really just paper, but it's a good thing we have it. Before money, people had to barter like this. Hey, can I give you a full wrap bag for that full bag of beans?
A full wrap bag? That's a barter bargain.
Here you go. Hey, this is only a half full wrap bag. This was not a fair exchange of rats and beans. The problem was determining a fair value. We needed something that we could all agree could be exchanged for goods and services. So the solution was money. And I mean actual paper money. I'm not just saying like the solution was money. That was so money. I'm saying like we needed money. I'm saying like that solution was paper dollar bills. Which one of these historical mega all-stars was instrumental in designing the first colonial money? Was it A, Benjamin Franklin, B, George Washington, C, Thomas Jefferson, or D, Aaron Burr? It wasn't Mr. Aaron Burr, sir. You guys only know these names because of Hamilton. I'm just pointing that out. If you said A,
You get an A+. Mr. Penny Saved is a Penny Earned. Benjamin Franklin was the first person to print colonial money. And he put all kinds of phrases and pictures on the money so that you might actually learn something when you're inspecting those dollar bills to make sure that they're actually real. He wanted money to, quote, make an impression on the mind. And those colonial dollar bills, the denominations were all over the place. There was like an $80 bill and a $6 bill with a picture of a beaver on it. I know this one's not fake because it's got the picture of a beaver on it. Speaking of forgotten denominations, which of these coins never existed in American currency? Was it A, the half penny, B, the half dime, C, the trime, or D, the 30-cent piece? If you said C, the trime actually existed. Look it up. It's a 3-cent dime. It's a real thing. I wish we still had the trime. That sounds pretty cool. Hey, man. You got any trimes? I'm trying to get a soda. No, actually, it's D. It's the 30-cent piece. I made that one up. Back in the day, colonial money was weird and wonderful. Back then, you could get a full rat bag for only 5 trimes. You know, today, we're so used to the way our money works, we rarely stop to think about what's actually on it or how much it's actually worth. Jesus knew that money was going to make an impression on our minds, so he determined where you could add the most value with your giving. Let's say you get some money. You're probably going to spend some of it. That's cool. And I know you're gonna save some of it because that's really smart, but the first thing you're gonna do, because you live a life of generosity, is you're gonna look for an opportunity to give some of it away. That's where Jesus said we should start with our tithes and our offerings. Oh man, we've all heard this before. What does tithe mean? Come on, shout it out. 10%. We already know this, right? We hear this all the time. It's 10%. A tithe is giving back to God 10% of what he gave to us. And then an offering is anything above and beyond that. As you plan to be generous, Jesus told us who we should give our money to. He said we should focus our giving on people with needs and people sowing seeds. People with needs are orphans, widows, people dealing with poverty or food scarcity. And then people sowing seeds are people in the local church and missionaries. Do you have any idea how much the world can change when you give to people with needs and people sowing seeds? You're participating in the restoration of the world. Your giving is a chance to put the world back to the way that God intended it. You're adding value. So look for ways to be generous. Start with 10%, but don't stop there. Make an impression on some minds by living a generous, generous life.
I'm the quiz man, goodbye.
Mark and Luke were friends of Jesus who loved to tell stories about him and what they saw Jesus do when he was on earth. One story they both tell is about a time when Jesus was sitting in the temple watching people put money in the offering box. He was watching as crowds of wealthy people were bringing large sums of money to give. They dropped off any extra treasure they had laying around. But then a widow who was poor and didn't have much walked up to the box. She pulled 2 small coins out of her pocket. These coins weren't symbols of wealth. They were the smallest currency available, called mites. They were like pennies. It was all she had, and she gladly put it all into the offering. Jesus jumps up and says, "Did you see that?" His disciples gathered around. Mark and Luke were ready to take notes. Jesus said, "That woman just gave the most." Somebody was probably like, "But it was only 2 small coins. Didn't you see that wheelbarrow of cash that the last guy brought?" And Jesus says, "Can't you see? She gave everything she had. Her 2 small coins are worth more because it was a sacrifice. That was all she had to live on. Instead of applauding the way the wealthy people gave, Jesus gave his recognition to the devotion of the poor widow. She made it a priority to give to others over her own needs. It might seem upside down, but that's how God's economy works. Just like Jesus saw the widow's heart, God sees your heart when you give. Generosity isn't always about how much you give, but also how much it costs."
This month, you know, we've been talking all about generosity. And today I wanted to just speak to you about one of the lies that people talk about when it comes to generosity. And that is this, that you have to have money and give money to be generous. Although having money and being able to give money is a great way to be generous, another way that you can be generous is by giving of your time. Maybe it's simply just giving somebody a piece of encouragement or making somebody's day by shooting me a text message saying, hey, hope you're doing well, I'm praying for you. And the last way that you can be generous is through your talents, whether that's serving at your campus on the weekend or serving a neighbor or, like we are today, serving with one of your local mission partners. And here's the deal when it comes to being generous. You can't just accidentally be generous. You have to plan to be generous. You know, it is said, if you fail to plan, then you plan to fail. And so with your generosity, make a plan. If you're going to go serve somewhere, write it on your calendar, call ahead, make sure they know you're coming. Or maybe you're gonna serve the homeless. You can always just pack a bag full of bread and snacks. That way, if you see somebody in need, you can simply give it to them. But just like I said, you can't just accidentally be generous. You have to plan to be generous. And be prayerful with your generosity. Don't just give randomly. Ask God what it is that He wants you to give, and then follow and trust in Him.
I think that we handled this hot topic very carefully.
This drink was awful.
You don't have to have money in order to be generous.
You can share your resources, your encouragement, as well as your attention and your skills.
Money can be harmful, but it can also make things better.
Plan to be generous with what God gives you, and you won't overthink it. Until next time,
enjoy the ride!
They're still going.
That was such a great lesson about generosity, wasn't it?
It sure was. Our faith declaration this month is, I am generous because God is generous with me. Friends, don't forget that God wants us to be cheerful givers.
Yes, God is generous with us and shows us how we can be generous with others. We are meant to live a generous life just like Jesus.
Let's all pray to God to give us generosity in our hearts and have eyes to see the needs of others around us.
We will see you next week, and don't forget, it's a great day
to be a church kid!
Yeah! And don't put clam chowder on your head or your tire.
Church kid show, church kid show, church kid show.
Church kids, in case you didn't know, we wanted to tell you that Jesus loves you. Yes, you. And He loves you so much that He died on the cross for your sins so that we could have salvation, which means we are in right standing with God. When we ask Jesus into our heart to be the leader and Lord of our life, we no longer have to walk in fear or in shame, because when God sees us, He sees the righteousness of His Son, Jesus. Salvation is a free gift to anyone who says yes to Jesus. In fact, in Romans 10:9, it says this: if you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. So if today you want to make the decision to make Jesus the leader and Lord of your life, now is your moment. Are you ready? As a sign of support, let's all pray this together. Lord Jesus, welcome to my world. I ask you to come into my heart and to forgive me of all of my sins. I decide today to follow you and to make you the leader and Lord of my life. I believe it, I receive it, and I will never be the same again. In Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer for the first time, we are so excited for you. Make sure to tell a Church Kids leader so we can celebrate with you and give you next steps.